It is time, once again, to attempt Mega Man Buster only. Now, I could be cheesy and use my save state because my emulator just saves the state whenever I exit. But, nah, I deleted that VOD anyway. So we're starting back from scratch. And since nobody's going to be here in minute one, I'm just going to go ahead and select the first boss. I just pick Guts so that way when I go fight a Lek, I don't have to backtrack. Hey Josh, what up? What? Jump down, thank you. Goddamn bullet sponges. You thought Destiny had the idea. Oh no. You're gonna watch me, eh? Alright. Well, appreciate it. Well, I can usually beat Gutsman without being... I'm not leaving it up to chance. Nah, screw it. I don't feel like grinding for 10 minutes. Easy peasy. All right, since people are actually in here. Voted before the poll came up. Good job. All right. No other takers? So the butt to whoop will be cut, man. Cutman's level layout is so bad. Like, just ladders that lead to nowhere. Random inefficient platforming. Oops. Like, why would you bother going over there? I know, they really phoned it in on a stage design. And the fact that the stage repeats. I mean, I know all the other stages repeat to a degree, but like, it's very obvious of Cutman. Oh my god, when do you drop health, please? Nobody gives a shit about points. All right, that's Cutman down. Who is the next ass to kick? Thank you. We got a vote for Bomb. Anyone? Bueller? No. Looks like it's just you and the three lurk bots. So we go to Bomb Man. Nice. Always gotta love it when you get the random one-up drop. I forgot, Mega Man 1, you're not spike immune when you're, in the damage state. Gonna get hit by every one of these, Jesus. Yep. Infinite respawning ass. Bomber, let's go. Invisiroll. Alright, that's Bomb off the table. Fireman next. Anybody else? Who else would like to cast their vote? Crickets can't vote, so Fireman it is. Jump too early. Oh well. Days where I wish I had Magna Beam. Because I don't even think it's safe to pass under those things. Like, at all. If you had Slide, sure. Topside turrets. Such a pain in the ass. And then we get to the biggest pain in the ass of all, this boss. Absolute dicketry that is that turret. Okay, there we go. I mean, you say that, but then there's like Bubble Man and Cut Man. Metal Man, you know, just bosses that are total bitches. I forgot you can just outpace them. This fire doesn't do that much damage. Alright, fire or ice? Fire or ice? Electrize. Just beat fire. Okie dokie. Black man it is. joiners care to vote? Yeah, who am I kidding? If I had any singing talent, I'd, you know, remix this track to go, I hate this stage. Yeah, it's one of the better tracks in Mega Man. Right, why did I go this way? I totally hit that guy. I don't have the magnet beam, so that is just a pain in the ass. Speaking of, though, made it through. Which means I get to the checkpoint. I mean, if I can get him in an RNG loop, I might actually be able to beat this without dying. Oh yeah, and not touch the electricity, which I always do. Oh, would you look at that? Well, he busted out of his loop. I can't kill him anymore. Well, oh, yes, that's why I do the RNG loop. Because without it, like, there's no way I'm beating him, Buster Only. Trying to jump properly and rhythmically shoot, not in my repertoire. Well, that's a repeat performance. You pretty much have to jump the second the fight starts.
Die!
And I don't feel bad for cheesing him at all. All right. Where are we going? I have a feeling it's Iceman. Yes, for the second time, the open BOR thing. It's not good. In a world where Mega Maker exists, that game does not need to. What? Oh, okay. So, thanks to a brilliant coding oversight, if they're spawning their bullets, it overtakes their platform hitbox. Dang it. I was going to say something about X not existing, but considering I'm playing Mega Man 8 Roll, yes, X did exist. Yo, what up, Bob? Almost certain that Daniel Bryan is signed with AEW, huh? I've heard about that. I also heard that there was a debut tonight. Shit. Yep, there are CM Punk reports too. Ladies and gentlemen, the RNG platform. It can go up, it can go down, it can go left to right, but it's just deciding to stay here. Yeah, the AEW roster is already, like, full to the brim. They're gonna have to either let some people go or make multiple shows. The Rock isn't in WWE, and he has no interest in wrestling anymore. Well, he's on a Legends contract, I guess. Because there's no way they're not going to do Rock and Roman Reigns again. Or, no wait, they've never done it before. Okay, this is ridiculous. I'm speeding up, just to see how long this goes. Yeah, screw it. I'll be back in a sec. Alright, I'm back. And yeah, the new live event is AEW Rampage. It's the one that Mark Henry's, hosting. Right, so they're announcing another one? At that point, they're going to have more, they're going to have more show than WWE does. Oh, it's going to be the, like, super card? Well, there were some New Japan people in the audience, from what I saw from Matthew. Oh, a live event, yeah. It's not really a debut, because, I mean, Bullet Club is already AEW anyway. You mean Moxley? For the IWGP United States Championship? Son of a bitch. Archer isn't winning. Yeah, I'm not surprised. Like, I'm sure it's a damn good match, but Archer's not winning. Archer doesn't win anything. Like, he's AEW Samoa Joe. He's a big bad threat that never gets a job done. I mean, am I wrong? Wait, how could a Texas Deathmatch be lame? Well, other than it's just a standard death match with the name of the place that they're in strapped to it. We're gonna have a Wichita Falls death match. Well, that's disappointing. Jericho and Cassidy, huh? I wonder what they were up to. Well, never mind. I know what Jericho is up to. He's running through the circles of hell of MJF. I don't remember what Cassidy was up to. Dip. Happened again. I'm game over to these shit platforms. Oh yeah, Cassidy versus Blade, right? I mean, that's not bad so long as Blade still looks legit. Because, like, if there's one team, if there's one tag team in AEW that I can see not doing comedy, it's Butcher and Blade. Well, them and FTR. But FTR did Usy hot, so who knows? The first time Cassidy does take Owens level spots. Should see his shit on the indies. Dude took nasty bumps. There's apparently different rules on those platforms from when you're taking damage to when you're not. Is I did a Mega Manathon a while back, but that made me play 7 and 8, and I hate myself for it. So this time I'm doing Buster only, but I'm skipping 7 and 8. I might not do 9 and 10, but we'll see. Yep. Slide physics. Something big happened at Fighter Fest? No. Was it that Jeff Bailey finally got in a wrestling ring and everybody found out he couldn't wrestle and he's all pomp and no circumstance? I'm sorry, I hate the guy. Debated in the chat. Oops. Yes, clearly CM Punk showed up. So yeah, Josh, to properly answer your questions, what's planned is Buster only Mega Man 1 through 6. I might do 9 and 10. And frankly, I only wanted to do 1 through 6 because of the roll chance right hack. Because it's so good. And she's so cute. You know, I kind of hope CM Punk shows up, because if he does, Colt Cabana's a face right now. He'd have to play a heel, and then it just mimics real life. What the fuck was that? You saw that, right? I just tapped right slightly to move over, and then I just gravitate to the ground. Yeah, I swear Dark Souls got their physics from this game. Yeah, from Soft, I mean. Because Demon's Souls and Dark Souls are exactly like that. You stand to the next to the edge of a platform, you just teleport into the void. No, I don't think I will. I think I'll continually die until... No, NES hard is dying because you don't know. not dying because of shit controls. Clearly, the Mega Man developers thought so as well, because there's no other, this is the Mega Man with the worst platforming out of all of them. Yeah, that's not Nintendo hard, though. That's just bootleg hard. Hey, kids, you like jumping with B, right? Fuck off, bad dudes. Yeah, better than jumping with up. I mean, that's why I got a hitbox, because I don't even like jumping with up in fighting games. I'm like super paranoid with these things now. That didn't happen. Nah. Not doing rewinds. Well, then you might want to have a word with the people who made Was it Batman Returns, I think? Yeah, Batman Returns on the SNES. Because that was the first time Midway, NetherRealm decided that, oh yeah, let's just port our fighting engine into a DC thing, and nobody will notice that it's shit. Cough, Injustice, cough. Fuck Batman. Oh no. How dare you disparage someone whose superpower is being rich? Right through the platform. And it's not even like it's a sprite hack, because, like, Roll has the exact same hitbox as Mega Man. Yep, damage boost. You know, that might be the problem, is that since it's considered an enemy too, and you can pass through enemies when you're damaged, I don't know, maybe that's the bug. Well, it was either removed or fixed in later Mega Man, so we can have our gripes, but it's been fixed, so, you know. Coming back and playing this, it's like, well, what did you expect? All right, platform, go up. Go up, please. Don't make this death of boredom. I swear to fucking God. Oh. Progress! Take away too many hits. It's ridiculous. All right, Iceman. I have no lives. Shit. I can't tell what emote that is. It seems the penguins have stopped spawning. Lovely. Oh, because I just see like a fat yellow guy with a giant gaping maw. Flawless victory. Okay, now that I've blown up the emote, I can see it. And it's adorable. Small with bad eyesight? Eh. For the new poll. Where are we going? Nobody? Really? You guys suck. That's got me. I want this one. Son of a bitch. I can never get that pellet. Guaranteed damage. Thank you. I am the worst at timing this. Guaranteed damage. Plop. Here we go, platform hell number two. I wonder how many kids couldn't beat this game because, like, magnet beam isn't given to you unless you go out of your way to get that thing in Elecman's thing. Here we go. And before my internet shits the bed again. That's not a great start. God, am I ever happy they sped up the Yellow Devil in Mega Man 3. It's the mental attrition that gets to me. Like, waiting 30 fucking seconds between hits is just... ugh. What, the spinies? Yeah. And they're in Mario 1 as well. Hmm. Jerk. Yep, mentally checked out. This is why I'm not cut out for factory work. Or any kind of repetitive work, actually. Doesn't matter if I've done it a million times, I will space out and I will fuck up. I still would, believe me. Acceptable. I could swear I had two arms when I came into work today. What the fuck? Well, see, that's what gets me, is it's insanely repetitive music, and it's an insanely repetitive task. And even when I'm actively engaged, my mind wanders, so you can imagine just how out of it I get. Ah, shit. Here we go again. Jerk. What? Okay, now he's just adding to it. Stupid mustard ass motherfucker. Really? 3 out of 4 so far. And they just missed that one. Whoops. Another one. It's like half at this point. My bad, I missed on that one. I can't get that one, I just have to be at the apex of my jump. Oh, I just got him. Looks like I'm wearing shades. That's hilarious. And then immediately with more platforming bullshit. I always thought they were doing a max impression. Fuck off, Cugman. You're not even a real boss. Yes, jump into the projectile. Oh, shit. Running in place, jackass. Shocking, huh? You think you're funny? You think those puns are gonna fly here? Well, they are. Son of a bitch. Yeah, just seeing if you're paying attention, that's all. Of course he fucking respawns. Well, you seem to be constantly drinking something, so I don't feel bad. Yep, there goes the one up. Cutman. All right, a like butt. Let's go. Jesus, that thing does damage. How did they decide that that was a good damage ratio for a character that fast? That would be like if Quick Man did 6 damage to you. It's like, what the fuck? The turrets? Yeah, they're a pain in the dick. Especially because they low profile you when they're inactive. At least they're very predictable. I think you can get them in the loop. Okay. Operation Cheese Elect Man is go. Thank you. gonna go have a smoke. Be right back. And I'm back. And yes, Yasha, I do know about the random hacks. They're incredibly chaotic. It's just a damn shame some of the Pixel Perfect recreations in Mega Maker you're talking about can't use the proper assets because not all the assets are in the game. But they make a bunch of custom assets instead, which is weird. Like that Edgelord boss or the like ridiculous power-ups they put in. I don't think those assets ever made it into Mega Maker, though. I know they did their own custom Ghosts and Goblins as of late, which is really weird, but sure, whatever. You Did you not do that directly under me? Now you're just going to do it directly under me. Okay. I think I have to be in a corner. Oh no, Cut Man took his cut. I'm trying to figure out the pattern of how he shoots, and it seems to be random. The only thing that seems consistent about his behavior is that he'll jump when I shoot. That's what I get for mashing on the wrong buttons. Sad that as that message gets through to me, I'm already dead. Thank you. had him in a good rhythm. Yeah, it's just abusing loops. That's it. And time for Mega Clone. Who I have no idea how to beat. Jumping on me, you jerk. Yeah, seriously. Dodging hundreds of projectiles, but oh no, there's a machine. Better stay perfectly still. Okay, The clone's faster than you and likes to jump on you and does more damage. What the actual fuck? Do I just pray it goes the other way? Either way, now I gotta fight fucking Elec-Man again. Hitboxes, yay! So this is the checkpoint. I'll be thankful we don't have to look at that stage anymore. Oh yeah, the water area. Time to beat this boss without guts. I really need to learn their patterns. Okay. So they always go clockwise. So staying in the bottom left is probably the best bet. Except for the middle one, I just have to hope I kill it fast. Got him. It's easy if you're good at mashing. Son of a bitch. Dang it. What do you mean lag in an NES game? There's tons of it. Thank you. But since this is Buster only, I can't just magnet beat cheese through this. Drop health, you plick. Nah, nobody gets plick anymore. Nobody watches kids in the hall. Fully is a good one. Holy shit, stop jumping, Jumpy. Hey, my name's Bomb Man, but I'm gonna do what every other boss does, and I'm just gonna jump on your head. Fucking leg humping AI. And that's something they never got rid of. Hell, they even made it so that some bosses do more damage when they touch you than when they hit you with their weapon. Like Fireman. Who guesses coming up? He does such little damage with the fire, you're better off just out-tempoing him. Up the timing. So where do I start? Against Bombo, so of course. They don't even have the goddamn courtesy to give me a health refill. Like, seriously, how are you supposed to beat this guy without getting hit? It's ridiculous. Oh, and there's health and a one-up. Fuck. Troll RNG. I wasn't getting enough of it in Loop Hero. Here we go again. Time now. Thank you. That is such a ridiculous jump. Thank you. How did I make that on the first try? Jeez. I mean, you keep saying that, and I somehow keep progressing, so I'm guessing that's how it happens. It's the head versus wall technique. Okay, yeah, I'm going to burn more health trying to kill these things than just running, so... Hard. The real arcade experience in your own home. Yeah, sure, give me this. Don't give me shit controls and physics, but give me this. I am happy with this. I don't need long, intricate AAA stories that take like 20 hours just to get into the beginning of the game. Because frankly, I skip that shit anyway. Yeah, and surprise, surprise, I play mostly indie games. I love how Doom shat on the idea of, like, long-ass exposition dumps, and then in the very same game, ended up doing the same thing. And then Eternal just jumped the fucking shark. Oh, not beating Heat, man. Jesus. This isn't pixel perfect. Oh, buddy, if you think this is pixel perfect, you need to see the Celeste Seasides. Those are pixel perfect. Like, they're literally designed to be pixel perfect. Tough, yes, pixel perfect this ain't. Yeah, that's what I mean. Chapter 9. That is basically fuck you, speedrunners, the level. I mean, Celeste isn't the first one to do it. But definitely in the 2D platformer scene, they're the one who did it the best. And at least it makes thematic sense, unlike in Hollow Knight. Here's this brooding atmospheric Metroidvania. Oh wait, now it's Meat Boy. Look, you have to admit, it's very, very out of place. Like, yes, it's cool, it's fun, and it uses the mechanics in an interesting way, but it is so out of place for the game. Oh, they're on a time delay, it's not a height thing. Okay. Oh yeah, even just the throne room bullshit is still like... Oops. Wanted to see if it dropped health. I should grab that one up and that health up, though. At least the one up. ET on Atari isn't hard, it's just you don't know what the fuck to do. The big old difference. And there's a lot of RNG bullshit put in there. Yes, it's obtuse, it's asinine, but it's not difficult. How's this motherfucker outpacing me now? Before he was doing no damage. Because it was such a commercial flop, really. Jesus, that ice beam does a lot of damage. Just when you thought it was over, here comes the Gutsman. Who can just jump on you if he wants to. How much ET for the Atari 2600 is going for on eBay? I'm going to guess 500 US. Probably like 50 grand. Over a million? Yeah, fuck that. That's just some eBay dumbass dreaming that it's worth that fucking much. I'm sorry, but no. Then again, if one dumbass sets a price, another dumbass will pay it, so... who might argue? People buy RTX 3090s. Just when I think I got his AI pattern down, he goes and fucks it all up. Basically what Mega Man Battle Network is, though. Back in a sec. And I'm back. Too early. Wow. Twice in a row, the first guy drops a 1-0. And twice in a row, it disappears off the top of the screen. Bob, you're assuming that he lives in America and that he gives a flying fuck about OSHA. You know, like the rest of the building contractors. There's no use baby raging to Capcom about this game. They knew what they did wrong and they fixed it in the later editions, so... You gotta remember, this was very early in the NES's lifespan. The whole creating robots part is what puts me off and makes me think it's Japanese instead. They'd be Japanese designed, Chinese manufactured. Then it would be built with American money. USA! USA!
Bye.
No, I'm pretty sure Dr. Wily is in the too big to fail bracket, so he just got a government bailout. Because apparently America's lost touch so badly with the concept of money that they can just increase their debt ceiling. Because they know nobody's going to come to collect. Like your credit card company calling you and being like, yeah, you maxed out your card. You owe us quite a bit of money, and be like, no, I've just decided that I'm increasing my limit. So I'm not going to pay you until it's maxed out. Can't see how well that fucking flies. Gunman and fast food, man. Don't forget Angry Mall Shopper. No, it'd be The Karen would be the one to break the mold of the man/woman at the man-woman suffix. It would just be Karen. Oh, Mega Man's manager is Dr. Light. No, he got COVID in Mega Man 10, not Mega Man 1. Or sorry, Roboenza. Shit, I actually got my health back and I didn't lose it in the process. Amazing. Time to die on the spikes again.
Oh shit.
The death spikes and blasphemous. That's not supposed to happen. Please let me dodge one fire. Come on, you jerk. Jesus. Mm-hmm. Literal rapid fire? There's auto fire protection in this game, so I don't really care. Not doing it this go around. That's a little better. So you can out-tempo him with full health, but then now I have to beat Iceman and Gutsman without getting hit. Which isn't gonna happen. Where are you going, dude? Thank you. Thanks, man. Because in this game, there were no E-tanks. To be fair, this game is piss easy if you can't use the other weapons. Like, you just get Elecman's thing and you just do the pause trick. Literally every enemy's weakness. That I hate myself, it's that I like Mega Man. I mean, you say that, Bob, but I've done that. Final Fantasy I haven't beaten with just the normal attack command is 10, because it expects you to do other shit. And technically 7, because you have to kill Sephiroth on a limit break, but you know. Getting the full heal too. That's what passes off as an E-tank in this game. Oh, thanks, Guts, man. I can't actually get past him. I just have to pray to RNGesus that I actually get a good pattern with him. Because there is no fucking way else. Thank you. least in the rest of the games, they give you heal every time you beat a boss, which is nice. Well, Gutsman isn't really an RNG boss when you have, you know, abilities that you can use against him. I don't have that luxury. No, but the point of Mega Man was that it was like the arcade experience. That was the entire thing for the NES was, you know, the arcade experience in your home, but like the real arcade experience. Because it had the graphics, man. Thank you, Buttsman, for being a well-behaved Buttsman. Then after all that shit, the actual boss, yeah. At least there's a continue point here. If I have any lives left, which I probably don't. Oh, I do. Last one, though. Are we doing a little Nemo here? Jesus. At least little Nemo had some kick-ass boss music. This does not. Oh, well. Capcom learned well. Damn. 16 forms, though. There's only two. Oh, yes. Welcome to the last level of Mega Man. It's a bitch. Okay, well, it's not when you can use these lovely abilities. Oh, fuck yeah, points. Gotta get that high Mega Man score. You know, I say that, but there's probably somebody who, like, seriously does score attack in Mega Man. Because if a ridiculous category in gaming can be made, there's somebody who's dedicated their fucking life to it. Thank you. I now realize it would be more efficient to grab this thing than the 1-Up. Because I could get that in one pass. Oh well. Oh, thanks, Bomb Man. What the fuck? Really? The fire either lasts for like 2 frames or 30. And the freeze ate my jump. Great. Again, the fire just... All right, how many lives do I have? One. Yay! Okay, lesson learned. I can't go fully underneath the butt. Second fucking shot. I'm basically gonna have to learn how to bait it out every single time. Bait the bot butt. Bait the bot butt for a beautiful bounty. Now we're back to this shit again. I still gotta wait for it to come back in. That thing respawned when I paused. Interesting. I mean, it fully refills your health and weapons, so it's not like you need another one. No butts, man. Bad touch. That's a dick move. Got him. Oh, can't forget my clear points.
So many points.
Blue text with a red drop shadow. That's so readable. Yeah, unfortunately, the sprite hack had to mess with the palettes, and you get stuff like this. Oh, there we go. It only gets easier from here. No, it actually switched into the other role. Interesting. Well, I baited the bot butt, and it worked. Well, Luna and beer are good distractions, so I'll forgive you. Oh yeah, I can challenge again for more points! Fuck yeah! Go for the high score! Nah, screw that. I'll just give you a teaser for what's coming up next. I was gonna do this tonight, but my hand is fucking killing me. So we just got a preview of what's coming up next. And honestly, who doesn't love this music? Next time, Roll Chan 2.